say in 1988, I had this terrible condition, and the doctor, the very senior doctor from the whole of the province, said this condition cannot be healed. You can only take tablets for the rest of your life.
And what condition was it?
It was infection on all the joints, and it was deteriorating the joints. It was eating the different joints of the body. But it was also causing me depression and all that. It was very, very, and then a lot of headache. I was having a lot of headache, so it was a very terrible condition. So what actually happened is that time a teacher came from America, and she came to Nairobi in a church called St. Stephen's Church, and she was talking about healing. She had written two books about healing. And as she spoke, I said, this lady must have been sent from America by God for me. So I did not wait for her to finish to preach. I just walked to the front, and she said, young man, your faith has healed you.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Up to today, 27 years later, I've never taken one tablet. And
Amen.
The condition went and went and went, never to come back.
Mm-hmm.
And then in 2001, I had just lost my aunt, and I came to UK. I was finishing my PhD in Birmingham University, and I decided to go swimming in Brighton because I was just to relax. And when I was in the sea, a wave came. I don't know how to swim nicely, and the wave took me completely. I went with the wave. And I cried out to the Lord, and I said, my children, my God, my children, Lord, what will happen to my children? And the Lord literally sent his angel, and the angel held me in Brighton and threw me long distance from like the middle, well, not the middle of the sea, but right in the sea, and threw me to the sand, and I came and fell.
To the sun?
Sand. You know,
sand,
the beach,
oh,
yeah.
To the sand.
And they were the friends I was with. They saw me land there, and they said, what happened to you? I said, the angel of the Lord. So that God saved me from death. Literally, I had been carried by the water, and the Lord saved me. But that time, I was doing a lot of international business. I was traveling around the world, and somebody gave me poison. They must put poison either in water or in food, I don't know. But when I came back and arrived in the UK, I was in a lot of pain. A lot of pain here, there was a lot of pain. So I went to see the doctor in the Great Naval Hospital. And they tried to do something, they can't find any, they can't find infection until they discovered that my liver was getting infected and it was deteriorating, my liver now. And there was no hope for me. My only hope was death. And they said, oh, this kind of condition is very difficult condition. And it went on. Before they had thought it was different things and they could not get a solution. And obviously they were giving up on me. And again I prayed and I prayed and I trusted God. I was losing weight. This is not the Lucas I used to be. I used to be a very big person. And I was losing weight and I was deteriorating and it looked very bad. And I prayed and I fasted. Okay, the doctor told me, you can't fast, you're going to die. I said, I'd better die fasting. Instead of dying, not doing anything, I'll pray, and if I die, I die fast. And the Lord gave me victory. So he's a God who healed. Oh, the last one, 2013, I got a heart problem. And I was told by the doctors, if I had stayed one more day, the problem was so bad. It's not normally a serious problem, but when it goes beyond, it's called pericarditis. But there is the fluid that forms in your heart, at the bottom part of your heart. God just gave me the opportunity to go to the hospital at the right time. And I prayed,
Amen.
And I got the victory in Jesus' name. So I'm a living testimony of healing. That's my
Amen.
Personal healing. But I've also seen a lot of people being healed by the Lord in my ministry. You know, Wanjiko. You all know the story of Wanjiko. Wanjiko had been told that she's dead. I'd already been told that the Lord came and she was in a coma for many months and God raised her back from there and she's now living. So it's a powerful testimony for the glory of God. I believe it's a healing
gift.
Wonderful. Let me ask you, you said when the wave carried you, you saw an angel? Did
yes,
you see
an angel of the Lord, yes, yeah, and he was walking in the sea. and lifted me and threw me like that.
You saw the angel and
yes,
threw you back.
Yeah, big angel. Yeah.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Yeah?
With wings.
No. But very bright. Just white. Oh. I just saw very white. That's the way I know the angel. Very big. Mm-hmm. Walking in the water. Mm-hmm. So part of the feet were a bit inside in the water, but the rest of the body. But he was not getting right at the bottom of the water. Mm-hmm. And through me. Mm-hmm. And there were some people on the side of the sea, the people that are still living today, so it's not like, yeah, it's very, very good there.
Yeah. Wonderful. Hallelujah. Yeah.
Monica's man, and I said, I don't know what it is, but I'm just driving with my feet. I said, Pastor, you can't be driving with my feet on the side of the heart. Why don't you go to the hospital straight? I said, no, I'm not wrong. And the more I drove classroom, the pain was more. When I got to the house, I just said to my wife, I want to go straight to bed. She said, no, you come and talk to your children first. I said, no, I can't talk to you. So anyway, it was a bit of experience. If you know what I'm feeling, you can't even talk. But when I got to the bed, I just started sweating, and I was sweating, and I was sweating. And she came to the hospital, and she called the ambulance quickly. And the ambulance came very fast, and they put everything in my heart, and they said, oh, this is a serious condition. We need to take you very quickly to the hospital. So they put me in the ambulance and took me to the hospital.
So you're a living miracle, Pastor.
Oh, yes.
Glory to God.
That's why I preach miracles. That's why
Amen.
I come to tell you live in
Amen.
Jesus' name.
I receive it.
I live by faith.
Yes.
And I'm mixing my faith with yours.
Amen.
I'm starting
Amen.
My faith with
Amen.
The faith until it brings something that the whole of Scotland will know. That there is a God. There is a God in
Amen.